Acharya Max Online Class. Today we are going to see the chapter Trigonometry. Trigonometry அப்படினாலே triangle base பண்ணி sum solve பண்ணுவோம். First உங்களுக்கு hypotenuse side தெரியும். For example, triangle ABC. Triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. Here angle B is equal to 90 degree. Opposite of angle B is a hypotenuse. That means right angle to opposite are the hypotenuse side, right? That is AC is the hypotenuse, you know, right? Here trigonometry la eppadi base pannuvona inge inda two sides eduthukala AC idla eppadi ana eduthukala. So for example angle A eduthukuren, here theta appdi edukuren appadina theta ku opposite irukku opposite side, that is BC. BC is the opposite side. Theta ku adjacent irukku adjacent side. So BC is opposite side and AB is the adjacent side. In case angle C la theta irukku appadina AB is the opposite side and BC is the adjacent side. AC is hypotenuse. No change, right? Now we see trigonometric ratio, right? Near right angle triangle ABC, here angle B is equal to 90 degree. So theta enga eduthirukana enga eduthirukan. Basic ratios are first one sin theta, second one cos theta and tan theta, right? Sin theta is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse, that is opposite side, that is BC divided by AC. Then cos theta is equal to then adjacent side AB, adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. This AB divided by AC. Next one, tan theta. Tan theta is equal to opposite side divided by adjacent side. Opposite side divided by adjacent side. That is opposite side BC divided by adjacent side AB. Then reciprocal of trigonometric radius ratios of dina. Reciprocal of sin theta is cosecant theta. Then reciprocal of cos theta is secant theta. Then reciprocal of tan theta is cot theta. Then cosecant theta is equal to hypotenuse divided by opposite side. That is AC divided by BC. AC divided by BC. Then secant theta is equal to reciprocal of cos theta. Then hypotenuse divided by adjacent side. That is AC divided by AB. AC divided by AB. Next one, cot theta, that is reciprocal of tan theta. Then adjacent side divided by opposite side. That is AB divided by BC, right? Next one, exercise 6.1. From the given figure, find all the trigonometric ratios of angle B. Given diagram is A, B, C. Here angle A is equal to, angle A is equal to 90 degree. Then the diagram, namakku easy identify aagura mari change pandrom. Then angle A is 90 degree. So angle A, B, C. AB is equal to 40. Right. Then AC is equal to 9. Then BC is equal to 41. Here, from the given figure, find all the trigonometric ratios of angle B. Angle B. So here, opposite side is AC, adjacent side AB, then hypotenuse is BC. Right. Then first one, sine theta. That is opposite side. Wait. Here. Yeah, right. Sine theta is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So AC divided by BC. AC is equal to 9 divided by BC is equal to 41. Next one, cos theta. Then cos theta adjacent side AB divided by hypotenuse BC is equal to 40 divided by 41. Then tan theta is equal to opposite side AC divided by adjacent side AB, that is opposite side 9 divided by 40. Then cosecant theta is equal to reciprocal of sin theta. Then BC divided by AC is equal to 41 divided by 9. And also cos theta, then secant theta, reciprocal of cos theta is secant theta. Then BC divided by AB, then 41 divided by 40. Next one, cot theta. Cot theta is equal to AB divided by AC, that is reciprocal of tan theta. Then 40 divided by 9. 40 divided by 9. That from the given figure, find the values of first subdivision sin B, second subdivision secant B, third subdivision cot B, fourth subdivision cos C, fifth one tan C, sixth one cosecant C. First step, divide triangle ABC into two right angled triangles and then find AD and AC. Right. First step. That is A, B, D. That is the right angled triangle that is given. Here, hypotenuse is 13. Then, adjacent side is 5. That is, opposite side. Sorry, hypotenuse. Then, BD is equal to 5. Then, AD is equal to X. Right. Here using Pythagoras theorem, we know the Pythagoras theorem, in a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides. That is, AB square is equal to AD square plus BD square. So, solution, AD is equal to square root of then AB square minus BD square, then AB square, then 13 square, root of 13 square minus 5 square, then root of 169 minus 25, then root of 144. Therefore, AD is equal to 12. 144 is the square number, so 12 into 12, 144. Therefore, AD is equal to 12. Next one, in a triangle ADC, in a triangle ADC, ADC, AD find out one more, then DC 16, sorry, AD already find out 12, then now we find AC. Then AC is the hypotenuse. So AC squared is equal to AC squared is equal to AD squared plus BD, sorry, DC squared. Then AD squared 12 squared plus 16 squared DC. 16 squared 144 plus 256. We get 400. That is AC square, then AC is equal to root of square root of 400, we get AC is equal to 20. Then 20 into 20, 400. So AD is 12, then AC is 20. Let us try triangle ADB. ADB. Then 5, 12, then 13. Angle D is right angle. First equation, sine B. Sine B is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. Opposite side AD divided by AD divided by AB is equal to 12 divided by 13. 12 divided by 13. Right. Next one, second subdivision, secant B. Secant B, that is reciprocal of cos theta. Then cos theta is equal to adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. Here secant theta is equal to hypotenuse, that is AB divided by adjacent side BD. BD is equal to AB. AB is equal to 13 divided by BD, 5. Right. Next, third subdivision, cot B. Cot B, that is reciprocal of tan theta. Tan theta is equal to side, opposite side divided by adjacent side. Here adjacent side, that is BD divided by opposite side, then AD is equal to BD, 5 divided by 12. Next, fourth subdivision. Fourth subdivision, cos C is equal to, here let us say triangle ADC. Triangle ADC. Triangle ADC. Then ADC is equal to 16. Then AD 12. Then AC 20. Right. Then cos C. Then adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. Here adjacent side DC or CD divided by hypotenuse AC is equal to 16 divided by 20. 4 fours are 16, 5 fours are 20. That is equal to 4 divided by 5. Next, fifth subdivision, tan C. Tan C, that is opposite side divided by adjacent side. Opposite side AD divided by adjacent side CD, that is equal to 12 divided by 16. 3 fourths are 12, 4 fourths are 16. 3 divided by 4. Next, sixth subdivision, cosecant C. Cosecant C is equal to, that is reciprocal of sine theta. Sine theta is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. Here hypotenuse divided by opposite side. Hypotenuse AC divided by opposite side AD, that is equal to 20 divided by 12. 5 fours are 20, 3 fours are 12, that is equal to 5 divided by 3. That's all. Next one, third sum. If 2 cos theta is equal to square root of 3, then find all the trigonometric ratios of angle theta. So இங்க ரேஷியோ, அதாவது ஆப்போசிட் சைடு அட்ஜசன்ட் சைடு ஹைபோடனஸ் எதுவுமே கொடுக்கல. ஸோ டைரக்டாக கொடுத்துருக்காங்க. ஸோ ஃபஸ்ட்டு நம்ம அதை செப்பரேட் பண்ணணும். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன், தட் இஸ் ட்ரையாங்கிள் ஏபிசி. ரைட். கிவன் கிவன் 2 cos theta is equal to square root of 3. Then cos theta is equal to root 3 divided by 2. 2 shift to right hand side, then root 3 divided by 2. That is adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. That means here theta. Right? Then adjacent side, that is root 3 divided by hypotenuse. That is AC 2. Now we find BC. Here using Pythagoras theorem, then BC is equal to square root of AC squared minus AB squared. That is AC squared is equal to AB squared plus BC squared. So BC squared same place left side shift பண்ணோமா AC squared minus AB squared. The BC squared squared அந்த side shift பண்ணோமா square root ஆக மாட்டாயிடு. So BC is equal to square root of AC squared minus AB squared. Then AC 2 then 2 squared minus AB root 3. Root 3 the 4 squared. That is root of 4 minus 3. Root 3 the whole square we get 3. Then root of 1. BC is equal to root of 1. Therefore BC is equal to 1. That is opposite side. That is opposite side. First one sine theta is equal to opposite side divided by adjacent side. So 1 sorry opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So 1 divided by 2. 1 divided by 2. Next one cos theta is equal to adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. So root 3 divided by 2. Root 3 divided by 2. Next one tan theta is equal to opposite side divided by adjacent side. 1 divided by root 3. Next one cosecant theta, that is reciprocal of sin theta. So 2 divided by 1 we get 2. Next one cosecant, next one secant theta. Secant theta, that is reciprocal of cos theta. Then 2 divided by root of root 3. Next one cot theta, that is reciprocal of tan theta. Then root 3 divided by 1, that is equal to root 3. That's all. If cos A is equal to 3 divided by 5, then find the value of sin A minus cos A divided by 2 into tan A. Here cos A is equal to 3 divided by 5, that is adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. Then sin, we need sin A and tan A. So sin A is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So sin A opposite side illa. So now find out one more solution given cos A is equal to 3 divided by 5. Cos A, then A, B, C. Then cos A is equal to 3 divided by 5. That is adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. Here using Pythagoras theorem. Then AB squared, that is AC squared is equal to AB squared plus BC squared. Then we need BC. Then BC is equal to root of AC squared minus AB squared. Then root of AC squared, that is 5 squared, minus AB squared, that is 3 squared. Then root of 25 minus 9 is equal to root of 16, we get 4. Therefore opposite side BC is equal to 4. Opposite side BC is equal to 4. Right. Then sin A. Sin A is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. Then 4 divided by 5. 4 divided by 5. And tan A. Tan A is equal to opposite side divided by adjacent side. That is 4 divided by 3. Now sin A minus cos A divided by 2 tan A, that is equal to sin A, that is 4 divided by 5, minus cos A, cos A 3 divided by 5 divided by 2 into tan A. 2 into tan A is 4 divided by 3. Then here denominators are same. So 5, taking 5 as common, 4 minus 3, 1 divided by 2 fours are 8 divided by 3. That is equal to 1 into 5, sorry, 1 divided by 5 into 3 divided by 8. So 2 fractions divide by the first fraction of the second one reciprocal to multiply. That is equal to 3 divided by 5 8s are
40. That's all. Therefore, sine A minus cos A divided by 2 into tan A is equal to 3 divided by 40. That's all.
Next one, fifth sum. If cos A is equal to 2x divided by 1 plus x squared, then find the values of sin A and tan A in terms of x. Terms la vandu over term la x varum, right?
X ingra term vechi face panni eduka solliranga, right? Given cos A is equal to 2x divided by 1 plus x squared,
we need find the values of sin A and tan A. So we need opposite side, right? Then it is right angled triangle ABC. ABC is the right angled triangle. Cos A adjacent side divided by hypotenuse, that is 2x, then 1 plus x squared. Then BC is equal to square root of AC square minus AB square by Pythagoras theorem, right? Then AC square, that is 1 plus x squared, 1 plus x squared the whole square minus AB square, that is 2x the whole square. Then root of A plus B the whole squared formula, then A square plus 2AB plus B square, that is x square the whole square minus 4x square, minus 4x square, then root of 1 square minus 2x square plus x square the whole square, then plus 2x square, then minus 4x square, we get minus 2x square. Here A square minus 2ab plus b square. We know the formula A square minus 2ab plus b square is equal to A minus b the whole square. Here A is equal to 1 and b is equal to x square. Then 1 minus x square the whole square. That is root of 1 minus x square the whole square. Therefore BC is equal to 1 minus x square. BC is equal to 1 minus x square, that is BC 1 minus x square. Then sin A is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse, that is 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. And tan A is equal to opposite side divided by adjacent side, then 1 minus x square divided by 2x. That's all. Thank you.